Today, I am revisiting some territory that many other people, not the least of which Big Clive, has visited a fair few times, but this is the first time I've actually been able to do this. So, these, I'm sure you'll recognize by now, are, what do you call, personal portable air pollution generating devices, something like that. They, as most of us, I'm sure, are aware, have a battery inside them that that heats up a little coil of wire, which causes the liquid that's inside these to be vaporized and inhaled by whoever it is that's decided to buy them. Finding discarded single-use ones around here has been surprisingly hard. These, in the last year that I've been looking for them, keep my eyes open, these are the only two that I've found. And this one is almost identical to several that Big Clive's torn apart, so I'm not going to dwell on it. This one, however, I am going to spend a bit more time on because it has one interesting feature. It appears to be rechargeable, which means it's likely got a charging circuit in it. So I'll set that guy aside for now. I'll just quickly pop this one apart. I think that bottom part comes off. Yeah. Little O-ring comes at the bottom there. I can't remember. It's been a long time since I saw how Big Clive did these things. I think I might need some unreasonable force. Okay, there. There we got some goop and juice and stuff in there. But I think, oh, see that little blue LED flashing? You see that? So it's sensing that something's going on here. I don't really want to get this stuff on my hands too much. I don't think it's carcinogenic, but I don't know. So that is the little cartridge that got the liquid in it. This fiberglass insulation here is surrounding the little heating element. This is a little wick which picks up the liquid out of this thing here and delivers it into there. And down in here, we have some electronics. If we've seen any of these videos before, we should recognize we'll also have the battery in it. I said I wasn't going to dwell on this one for very long, but I'm wasting a fair bit of time on it. It's got an aluminum shell on it, which is kind of interesting. And I don't really want to push too hard on that lithium cell down in there. The whole point of this exercise is to get it out. There it comes. There it is. And that is the prize that we're looking for. This particular cell claims to be 3.14 watt hours, a 17350 form factor. I'm not expecting there to be protection on these cells because they are intended to be one-time use in the devices, so I doubt that they would pay extra for that. I'm just going to throw a voltmeter on there and see what we got. 3.33, so it's almost at the bottom of what its safe range is. So I guess I shall charge it up and we will just see what we can get out of this thing, or get into it, I guess, first of all. I'll do that off camera, of course, because battery charging is not that most exciting thing to watch. I'll let you know. I'll probably put it down in the description afterwards what this one came out as. But let's go on to the other one. And this is the one that I'm actually more interested in. It, okay. As I said, it's got a charging port on it. It's called the Mr. Fog switch, and it's got this little thing on the side here, so I'm not sure if that helps to lock it together or not. It doesn't seem to want to come apart though, so maybe we'll just remove that little bit altogether. I don't know, spudger? Sure. I am going to have to give all of my tools an alcohol bath after this to get this oily crap off. Okay, that didn't do much of anything. Now that's more promising, or not. Kind of like to save this pinkish side here, because that's the one that's probably got the charging chip and whatever else the what else would be in there? Well, the battery, obviously. It's got a charging circuit in there, though. Presumably, it's got some protection and stuff because it's intending it to be recharged. I don't know. What else could be going on in here? If it's rechargeable, though, does that mean it's refillable with the liquid? Possible? Am I going to need more than one spudger here? What's happening in there? I can't even see. Okay, destruction it is. That doesn't look like much of a smart charging circuit to me. Oh, and I bent the USB-C connector a little bit too. Damn it. Now let's lift the pouch cell off there. Give it a little bit of alcohol to help loosen up the adhesive on there. That comes off there nicer. Okay. Oh, good. The cell's marked too. 650 milliamp hour. That's not too bad. 3.7 volts again. 2.41 watt hours. Well, this other one claimed to be 3.14 watt hours. Similar size in that dimension, a little bit shorter or a little bit longer. Okay. And this one has the wires both going in that end. So what's going on? Little tiny screws on that. Sure, let's take that apart. Since I'm following Big Clive's lead here, I will also use the screwdriver that he made famous in electronics videos. So, okay, there we go. We have the red and black wires from the battery going inside here, and we have the two wires from this thing. Oh, it does have a bit of circuitry on it. HY20, H2A, and then a couple of what looks like resistors on there. And the capacitor. Another resistor over there. That was unexpected. So I looked a little bit more carefully, and that was actually an HY2D, which is just a basic PNP transistor, and the H2A is just a basic NPN transistor. Okay. So I spent a few minutes on this circuit board, and it is, like a lot of surface mount, a real pain in the butt to try and reverse engineer because the traces disappear underneath things and then pop through vias that are hidden behind components and stuff. So the best of my figuring, and I may have this a little bit wrong, but to the best of my figuring, this is what's going on that board. The USB V minus and the V minus going out of the module are the black wire. They're common together. The USB positive comes in through the collector of the NPN transistor. And the V plus going out to the battery is on the emitter of the PNP transistor. These two resistors over here, I measured them in circuit, so your mileage may vary, 2.6K and 2.3 and 23K. So that is biasing the base of this guy. This 1.3K here is basically the load of the load resistor for this NPN transistor, and kind of the base bias for this PNP as well. I'm thinking that that's doing a little bit of current regulation. See if you guys can figure it out, but that's the best of my knowledge. And again, this may not be accurate because this little monster is a royal pain in the ass to find your way around. Anyway, I'm not going to use that. If it had a proper charging chip on there, I would use it, but I think I'm not going to. I measured these two wires here, and they do connect in parallel with this, and presumably in parallel with whatever's going on inside here to do the vapomatic magic. This guy is charged right up to a full 4.0 volts. Which means that whoever disposed of this thing seemed to have it fairly well charged just before they disposed of it. And I'm guessing because this part is so light, that there's probably not any of that juice left in it. So let's just see if we can find the circuit in here that controls the thing. Wow, that's a sizable juice tank. There is the little magic doodad right there. It, as Big Clive showed in his videos, is basically a little pressure sensor that senses when the sucker is sucking on the thing and turns on the contacts to the heating coil guy there. And that's what's up in there. That's all that's in there. There's the two black wires, the one going to the battery and the one going to the charge circuit. And then the red wire coming in from the battery and the white wire going out to the charge circuit, or coming in from the charge circuit, I guess. Anyway, this thing is kind of oily and it's not the part that I care about anyway. So all that destruction to get a couple of lithium batteries. This one is a little bit low, but I think I can revive it. And we'll, now I have a couple of batteries that I can use for projects. Yeehaw! Use my alcohol to clean some of that snot off my fingers there, so that I can do this. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments on this, have you had any luck finding any of these things and salvaging batteries yourselves? It's been about a year or so, like I said, since Big Clive brought it to everybody's attention that these Vapomatic devices have rechargeable lithium cells in them that are fairly easy to salvage. So I'm wondering how many of you guys have found some, and have you found some cool projects to use them in? Anyway, I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say. Thanks for watching. Questions and comments, you know the drill. I'll talk to you later. And since I'm sure there's somebody who hung around to the end just to see if I'd mention it, I've been drinking Night Owl La Shop Stout from La Shop Brasserie. Yes, an Irish-style beer from a French-style brewery right here in the middle of Canada.